time now for Tina Griffin, the counterculture mom. Explain to people who have actual lives who the Wiggles are.
I have an actual life, so I have to explain to myself. Can you tell me who the Wiggles are? It looks like a ridiculous cartoon from the stuff that I'm looking at.
They're a group of youth entertainers, a children's program, right? And now right. they decide, now all of a sudden, wiggling is not enough for them. Now they're going to become the woke Wiggles. The Wiggles have apparently awakened, if you understand it. Our friends from down under, they're Australian, have decided that it's important to be inclusive as possible when they're wiggling their way into your kid's heart. They are introducing non-binary characters, including the gender unicorn. There it is. Shirley, Sean, the gender unicorn is now part of the Wiggles.
It's ridiculous. Yeah, the new popular children's show here, The Wiggles, has some new characters, like you said, and they're moving towards CRT, critical race theory ideology. You know full well what that all is. And just looking at The Wiggles, that's why I didn't have to do too much research. It looks totally idiotic to me. I mean, I'm speechless. I am speechless, and that doesn't happen too often. You and I talked about some kind of Dole Whip commercial deal about a year ago with the whole fruit ordeal, which we don't have to go down that road again, but it's all the same word choice, all the same colors, same ideas. In fact, if everybody wants to be unique, they're not doing a good job of that at all, coming from entertainment here at the moment.
And pretty much everybody who does kids shows now has decided that they better be woke. They better get on the bandwagon and start treating children as if they're adults. Adult content, adult characters, adult subject matter. It's like nobody actually wants to teach innocent children innocent learning. It all has to be now cutting edge woke nonsense.
That's about it. And these people who are creating this idiotic nonsense, do they not realize that 40 years from now or 30 years from now, they will be needing the assistance of these children that are still 5 years old, trapped in a 40-year-old body? They're not going to make it that much longer. So we have to invest in the future generation. Otherwise, the idiots pumping out content like this will be left on the wayside and not taken care of because there's no adults to take care of them.
Speaking of no adults in the room, we pivot now to Will Smith, who for the last 20 years, 30 years actually, has been behaving like your typical white celebrity superstar, right? All the privilege, all the perks, all the private plane rides. His wife is famous. His son is now an actor. He's decided he's got to come out and share his bona fides with us for his African-American buddies and the less fortunate African-Americans out there.
Honestly, what I would say is whatever Will Smith says, just do the opposite. I mean, we've seen his marriage advice, go have open relationships, who cares how many people we're with. They're constantly exchanging sexual partners. It's absolutely ridiculous. We blessed that through our app. You and I have covered that story before. And now he's basically saying things like this. He says that early on in his career, he did not want to make movies about slavery, but now he's ready to do that. While discussing his new movie, Emancipation, which is about slavery, he promotes the BLM movement and critical race theory, and he says that he wants Black Americans to seize the opportunities available to them, but to change their marketing tactics. And he says, quote, critical race theory should be called truth theory. And he also says that the simplicity of BLM was perfect and that anybody who tries to debate BLM looks ridiculous. He discusses defund the police and clarifies that he supports defunding the police, but he doesn't like the slogan because it's not a good marketing ploy and it could keep people from getting the job done. And yet, when I've been at these award shows over the years, seeing Will Smith, and even if we look up Google search Will Smith today at these award shows, you will see about 42 bodyguards around him, fully loaded with guns and ready to rock and roll, with police officers. So he is another Hollywood hypocrite that says no guns, no police, and yet at the same time he has taken half of our police force for one award show that he attends.
Well, gangsters, gangbangers and thugs. Now you know that Will Smith ain't down with the police. You now know if you cruise his Hollywood neighborhood, you're gonna be able to get some bling, ain't gonna be no cops there.
Then why does he have a 14-foot fence around his Beverly Hills Hollywood mansion?
Don't call out my man as a hypocrite. He know better than Snoop Dogg.
Yeah, it's about it. Let's just make a whole long list of hypocrites and blast that out to the masses as a free giveaway.
Did I just appropriate African-American culture?
Dr. Duke.
Did I appropriate?
I don't know.
I was just getting, in the words of Will Smith, I was just getting jiggy with it.
Just wiggle, wiggle.
Wiggle, wiggle, and get jiggy with it. Tina, all right. I'm glad we have a sense of humor, or else this would be depressing time. So we really appreciate you. Quickly, how do people find and access you?
Yes. Well, you know what? Just download our app and Run From Will Smith. You'll get a lot of great entertainment there, that even some clips of Will Smith from like 40 years ago before he went woke, on the Counterculture Mom app. Download it today. We got a team of people pumping out positive content for our kids, so they're not full of CRT and the other crazy ordeal going on over there. Many more cartoons to pick from than the Wiggles. We want our kids to be educated and to actually own businesses of their own and not be working for these Hollywood elites underneath them. Let's have our kids grow up to be responsible citizens that love their country and love America.